Welcome to All Saints Catholic School e-learning. The big idea we will be working out today is how to answer a 20 mark question relating to objectivity and values in sociology. Remember, this relates to your theory and methods unit. For this session, you will need to have watched the big idea video on this topic first. Before beginning this session, try to find a quiet place where you can focus and aim to have a pen and paper to hand so you can note down any of your ideas. By the end of this video, you will have recalled what objectivity and values mean and how they apply to sociology, considered both sides of the argument, and planned how to write an effective 20 marker essay for this topic. Before we begin, let's recall our big idea of objectivity and values. You have 2 minutes now to mind map all you can recall about the debate for this topic. Please pause the video while you do this. So, everyone has values, beliefs, opinions, and prejudice. Our values are influenced by many factors, including our class, gender and ethnicity, upbringing and experiences. You could have got down that given that sociologists are also members of society, can we trust that they study objectively without bias? You could have talked about early positivists and Marx, that values are not needed and we need to focus on science and fact. And you could have also got down Weber and mid-20th century positivists, values are needed to guide research and make changes in society. How does this all link to your topic? So paper 1 and paper 3 both have theory and method questions in. You could get a 10 or a 20 marker question on objectivity and values. Therefore, you need to understand both sides of the debate on whether values should or should not exist in sociological research. This will allow you to answer 20 marker effectively. Remember, these answers need to include AO1, AO2, and AO3 to achieve the highest band. Remember your structure. You need 2 paragraphs focusing on the AO1 content. These will be agreeing with the statement in your question. You then need 2 paragraphs focusing on your AO3 content. These will be disagreeing with the statement in your question. Each paragraph needs to be used in a PLC format. That means you must have a small criticism at the end of each of your paragraphs. You also need to include a large range, at least 4 sociologists, Durkheim, Comte, Weber, Marx, for example, plus real life application. So your activity today is going to be looking at how do the 2 sides of the argument compare with one another. We need to consider what each side argues about values in research. The key to understanding both is planning your 20 marker. So in this instance, AO1 is values should be included, are unavoidable in sociological research, versus AO3, values shouldn't be included, are avoidable in sociological research. It's pretty much values versus facts. What we need to do is explore what each side of the debate postulates, and therefore your activity is going to be planning your answer accordingly. By the end of this activity, you would have planned out your paragraph 1, 2, 3, and 4 and had a think about what your introduction and conclusion should be. Before you begin, let's try this together using a similar task. So, question, using your knowledge, evaluate the view that sociologists can keep values out of research. Paragraph 1, you need to think about who should I talk about? Needs to agree with the statement in the question firstly. So look at my example there. I've bullet pointed it, that's what you can do in your activity. Some classical sociologists like Comte and Durkheim would agree with the statement, believe that the creation of a better society was not a matter of subjective views. Instead, it is the job of sociologists to uncover the truth. Sociologists should be able to say objectively what is really best for society. Then the last thing you need to plan is your criticism, because remember, every paragraph needs to be a PLC. However, most sociological research is funded by someone other than the sociologists themselves. Therefore, the body that pays for the research controls the direction it takes and can lead to sociological research being unable to remain value-free. Now it's over to you. What we want you to do is I want you to plan the next 3 paragraphs in that 20 marker question. You need to include 1 more paragraph that is AO1, a PLC, and then 2 paragraphs that are AO3, the other side of the argument, the ones that disagree. Again, they need to be PLC paragraphs. If you need to, please pause this video while you complete this activity. Let's consolidate your learning. So what you can see here is some ideas of what you could have included in your 20 marker plan. Paragraph 2, AO1, is about Marx, another thinker that agrees that sociological research can be valued free. And can we please note that I've included the criticism? Marxism sees society as a conflict and strives for a class of society. Values have led to their conclusions. Paragraph 3, we're looking at Weber, The idea that there is no distinction made between the facts and values from Comte, Durkheim and Marx. And then again, I have added a criticism. Mid-20th century positivists tend to argue that their own values were irrelevant to research. And finally, paragraph 4. Some sociologists oppose both these views, and we're looking at committed sociology. Again, I have added a criticism. Beck agrees with this and says that sociologists need to take the side of the underdog. Yours may look a little bit different to this, but that's okay. The other thing that you could do to stretch and challenge yourself is, what would you include in your intro and conclusion? And finally, is there any way you could question the question if you haven't done so already? Great work. Today you have managed to recall what objectivity and values mean, consider both sides of the argument, and you've managed to plan a 20-marker question for this topic.